Fellow South Africans, my name is Nocawe Mafu, a Member of Parliament and Deputy Minister of Sports, Arts and Culture. Part of our mandate as the department is to manage and support the Social Cohesion and Nation Building Programme. Celebration and commemoration of our national days is pivotal to this programme as government. The 27th of April this year, however, will be a day like no other, as the nation pause and reflect on the meaning of freedom, given the current challenging context of a national pandemic, COVID-19. While this moment has potential to send us into despair, we should also take stock of the unique opportunities this challenge has presented. Some of the most indelible markers of this COVID-19 challenge is the extent to which it has engendered acts of human solidarity across the bounds of race, class, religion, and many other axes of difference. We have seen sectors across the broad spectrum joined together by unity of purpose. We convey our heartfelt thanks to business and civil society, including the religious fraternity, for having standing up for the greater good. We salute our healthcare workers, security personnel, and those in other trades and occupations in the essential services for staying the course and making the huge personal sacrifices for the welfare of us all. This is what freedom is about. Freedom is not only about exercise of rights, it is also about recognizing the attendant obligations that correspond to those rights. It is about the sense of duty in safeguarding the welfare of others, especially the most vulnerable in society. That's what freedom enjoins us to do. As we reflect about this Freedom Month this year, I want to make this impassioned plea to us all as fellow compatriots to make a solemn pledge to assist in whatever way we can in the battle against COVID-19. To do so will be to heed the call that freedom enjoins us to do. As many of our children remain at home, let us ensure that they are never put in harm's way, that they are protected and cared for at all times, and that any incidents of abuse are reported to authorities. As most women are having to stay at home with abusive spouses and without much reprieve, given the watertight lockdown measures, let's ensure that we call out all perpetrators of gender-based violence in our communities. Let us break the silence. Let us break the chain of abuse. In that way, we will have lived and heeded the call in terms of what it means to be truly free. Happy Freedom Month, South Africans.